people.
Yes, sir.
Johnsburg is not black people. Those are only white people. We put you in the confinements and the conditions that you're in so you can't kill one another. Right. So you can't fight one another. So you can rob one another. And you damn black people, you always blaming each other all the damn time. Blame who the damn brain's supposed to be on. Right. And that's the damn white man. He's the devil on this damn earth. Come on. That man, it is high time. What's I didn't say later. He said now, okay, it's high time. You people are gonna find out. You're gonna find out the hard way. Okay? They put up a makeshift noose, okay, right in front of the White House. How did you Negroes miss that one right there?
Bring it up.
They put up a hanging noose, okay, right in front of the White House, and you Negroes still singing, we shall overcome. You Negroes are simple as hell, man.
Right.
How the hell can you Negroes talk about love and unity when there's a time of war right now? And guess what's gonna happen? Okay, during this inauguration, I'm gonna tell you exactly what's gonna happen. These white boys gonna put out a full-fledged war, okay, on black people. Okay, if you think we're playing, these scriptures are accurate and they're exact. Okay, they're accurate and they're exact, and history always repeats itself according to the Bible. Please answer the first chapter after you read this one. Come on. High time to awake. Oh, sleep. Most I said this black man. He said it's high time, okay, to wake up out of sleep. Okay, because you Negroes, you've been sleeping a little bit too damn much, man. You Negroes love to sleep, man. Okay, mentally and physically. You Negroes gotta be to work by 9, you're up at 8:55 and try to get ready. Okay, you get that extra 5 minutes of sleep. You black people have been sleep too damn long, man. Mentally and physically. Come on.
For now, it's our salvation.
Uh-oh, the Most High said this. He said, now, not later, is our what?
Salvation!
And the Most High said, now is our salvation. What?
Nearer.
Okay? Because salvation just means what? Saving. Okay? Just saving. That's all. Okay? The people that need saving are the Negroes, Western, Puerto Ricans, the minorities. Haitians, Dominicans. Okay? The North American Indians. Okay? We need some kind of saving. Okay? Because we're the only people that's in distress. Okay? We've been in distress. Okay? For the last past 400, okay? Over 400 years, man. Okay, the white man been sitting back, and he didn't never lay these things to heart. He never laid these things to mind, man. Okay, it's gonna come back on him sooner or later. All right, this is the caveman of the earth. How the hell did the white man get up on top of us, the Most High? Okay, put him up in the caves, and all of a sudden the white man came out of 3 BC and started beating up over the kings of the earth. That was a plan by the heavenly Father. Okay, the white man ain't smart enough to rule the earth. That's the reason why the earth is the way it is now, because he's proof and he's a damn jackass.
Right.
So how the hell can he be the smartest man on this planet? Okay, but he done destroyed the whole damn earth, man. Spilling up oil in the water, making up viruses to kill people.
Yeah.
Okay, making up cigarette smoke to kill you and kill your lungs, teaching your kids lies, man.
Alright,
this man has proved to be the damn dummy, man. Okay, giving homosexuals, okay, lesbians rights. Okay, you can't populate the earth, okay, by a man and a man, okay, assimilating damn sex, okay, yeah, one another. That's a damn fool, man. Come on.
Our salvation, nearer than when we believe.
The Most High said this. He said, the Most High said, our salvation, okay, is what?
Nearer.
The Most High said this. He said our salvation is what?
Nearer.
The Most High said, wake up, black man. Okay, our salvation is near. Okay, we believe. Okay, we're just about at that corner. We're the last generation, brother. Okay, what you're seeing right now, okay, is similar. Okay, it's going exact, just like the Heavenly Father prophesied in the Bible. Okay, when you read the book of James, the 7th chapter, when it talks about, okay, the man of gold and all the way down to the clay foot. Okay, guess what? We're living in that clay foot right now, man. Okay, we're living in the clay foot. This is the old bubblegum kingdom that we live in, man. Old sheet rock, okay, society we live in, man. Old cheap society, man. Okay, the so-called white man is a generic version, okay, of a so-called black man. Okay, he knows that. Call it a real.
Ecclesiastes chapter 1 and verse 9. The thing that hath been.
Hey, brother, guess what? The Most High said the thing, okay, meaning kingdoms, okay, in this case, the Most High said what?
The thing.
Most High said the thing, okay, meaning kingdoms in this case, come on.
That hath been.
All the Romans, okay, okay, the Babylonian Empire, the Most High said the things that have been,
it is that which. Shall be.
Most High said it. It's the things that shall be. Why?
and that which is done is that which shall be done.
False, I said that which is done, okay, is that which shall be done, okay? Meaning what?
And there is no new thing under the sun.
False, I said this. He said there's no new thing under the sun. Okay, meaning the same kingdoms that fell before, okay, the same things are going to happen again. History always repeats itself over and over and over again. Okay, that's the reason why the things that you see in the news and the things that you see going on now, okay, are the same things, okay, that history predicates. Okay, the same old thing. Yeah, this is the devil right here.
That's right,
it's the devil. Okay, this is where things are. Yeah. This is what America, okay, has taught us, that this is Jesus Christ.
Right.
Okay, but this is not Christ. Say it again.
Thomas.
There you go. Okay, that's right. But you do know that Christ was a so-called black man, don't you?
That's right.
Okay, good. Okay, good. Where did you learn that? Okay, good. Okay, good, good. So you know that Christ, right, good. So you know that Christ is a black man. Okay, all right, finish reading up.
There is no new thing under the sun.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 21.
Prepare slander.
Uh-oh, here it comes right here. Okay, but this is one thing right here, okay, that the so-called Europeans don't understand that's going to happen to them. Read it one more time, brother.
Prepare slander.
Mosiah said this. He said this is what has to happen, okay, to the European nation. Okay, the Most High said, this is what's happening right here. Read it again.
Prepare slaughter!
That's exactly what's happening in America. Okay, the Most High is preparing slaughter. Why?
For his children!
The Most High said he's preparing slaughter, okay, for the children of the Europeans. Okay, why?
For the iniquity!
For the iniquity, meaning the crimes and the sins. Why?
Of their fathers!
Of their fathers, man. Okay? The so-called white man, woman, and child, they have to pay for what their fathers did.
That's right!
They ain't gonna get away, okay, scot-free with this. Okay, this is not, listen, let me explain something to you. Okay? Like I've been explaining to you. Hand me that stick right there, young prince. Okay? What you gotta understand is this. Okay? You know what I'm going after this. You see the hands of these so-called black men, okay, the children and the women.
Teach them over.
These right here. What you got to understand is this, okay, is that somebody has to pay for this right here, okay? The things that the so-called white man did during the time of slavery, okay, from the 1600s all the way up until today, somebody got to pay for this. Hold that right there. And the Bible tells us so, okay? But what you got to understand is this, okay, is that the Bible has been misconstrued, okay, and has been misrepresented. Okay, fine. Okay, people on this earth. Okay, but this right here, the hangings, the catastrophes, the lynchings. Okay, what we've been through as a people, somebody got to pay for it. Read it one more time. Guess who? Come on. Read it again. Isaiah 14:21. Come on, brother. Don't move it
now. Prepare slaughter!
Oh, that's what's going to happen. The Most High said he's preparing slaughter.
For his children!
For his children, the European children. Come on.
For the iniquity!
For the crimes and the punishments and the sins. And this is an iniquity. Okay, this is wrong, okay, to string up, okay, innocent people like this, Negroes, Puerto Ricans, Latinos, okay, Columbus Seminole over here, pulling up, okay, the North American Indians, okay, during the time when we came over to America, and spreading smallpox. Okay, the North American Indians, they was over here minding their own damn business for this, huh? They didn't ask Columbus to come over here and give them smallpox, man, okay, and give them diseases, okay, and bring down pigs over there, man. Okay, because why? Because, listen, okay, there was no pigs, okay, over in America before Columbus came over there.
Right?
Because why? Because the Most High said this, prepare what?
Slaughter!
The Most High said somebody got to pay for prepare slaughter.
For his children!
For his children. Okay, because why? Because look, if you got a tree, okay, in your backyard, okay, and you want the tree to stop yielding fruit, what do? You just cut the branches off? Okay, if you want the tree to stop yielding fruit, or do you what? You pull it from the roots, okay, so it can stop yielding fruit altogether.
That's
okay,
right.
Come on.
For the iniquity of their fathers!
The Most I said for the iniquity, okay, meaning the crimes of their fathers,
that they do not rise, nor possess the land, nor fear the face of the world with cities.
That's what has to happen to the so-called Europeans.
That's right.
Because if you don't get rid of the so-called Europeans, okay, you will have more of this. Okay, you will have more of that. Turn that sign around right there. Okay, you definitely will have more of this right here. Okay, if you came in power again, because like the brother said earlier, okay, it's because of that perpetual hatred, okay, that he has, okay, towards the children, okay, of Israel. Because why? Because it's innate, okay, in, okay, the so-called Europeans that hate their guts automatically, man.
Okay,
it's innate in them. Listen, you don't have to, okay, go to a European, okay, and see it, or try to beg and negotiate with him to love you. It's innate in them to hate you, man. That's the reason why they treat you, okay, like that song a long time ago. Why they treat you so bad? Okay, who made that song, brother? Why they treat you so bad? Okay, you guys been taking a damn double man for years, okay, they probably. Okay, for years, okay, they probably. The damn man still hasn't given it to you yet, man. Who you guys gonna get tired of them begging the damn white man and singing that old song? We shall overcome. You niggas ought to be sick and damn tired, okay, singing that damn old slave song, okay, year after year. And the white man sits back and laughs at you damn niggas, man. Okay, because why? Because it's still the damn slave mentality that we got you in. Okay, the shackles is off the damn feet, and they're off the damn ankles, they're off the damn necks. Okay, now they're going to damn brain. Okay, but you Europeans, you gonna pay, man. Okay, one thing you didn't consider, and one thing you didn't lay a heart. Okay, when he's telling the so-called Negroes, it's that the Heavenly Father said exactly what the hell he was doing. Okay, the so-called Negroes have forgotten, because yet the Most High hasn't forgotten this. Okay, the Most High hasn't forgotten this. A supreme being by the name of Yahweh, okay, and his son Yahushua, he hasn't forgotten this right here. You better have forgot, okay, you better not want to know this in the day. It's shameful, okay, that he's sitting up here, you got black men talking about the white men, because you niggas just, get me mad, man. Negroes get more mad at us,
right,
because we're talking about the damn white man, the oppressor, okay, more so the oppressor than damn self.
That's right!
That's the same way we talk about Yahweh Shah. That's like you know that was a black man. The man wasn't doing nothing, really, the man ain't do nothing, they hungered and lynched him for not doing a damn thing. That's how you know that was a black man.
That's
okay,
right.
The man got killed for doing absolutely nothing, man. Just the same way the so-called white man got that hatred, okay, towards you today, okay? What you got?
Unarmed black man, there you go, come on. Isaiah chapter 14, verse 21.
Bring it up!
Prepare slaughter for his children!
That's right, that's what has to happen to America, okay? You gonna hold that call on me. That's what has to happen to America, young man, okay? And all the, okay, but to get, okay, you can't get rid of just some of the cancer, okay, that's in your body. If you want your body to heal, okay, you gotta get rid of all the cancer. And the so-called white man has been that cancer, okay, to this entire earth, man. He's the problem for the whole earth. You niggas, you can play with yourself, and you can play games all you want. The so-called white man, woman, and child is the problem of this whole damn planet,
right?
You niggas, you can vote. You can say whatever the hell you want to say, okay, you can listen to your behavior, my friend, okay, talk about love and trust, okay, but the so-called white man is deep devil, okay, he is deep devil,
right,
okay,
right.
That deep Bible speaks of.
Right.
I'm gonna read it, Father, come on. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 and verse 15.
Fuck
it up! That which have been is now, and that which have been already.
Also, I said the things that have been before and the things that you see here with your naked eyes today, come on.
That have been already.
That have been already. Okay, meaning history repeats itself. Come on.
The Most High required that which is past.
The Most High said he required that which is past. Okay, meaning history repeats itself, young man. Okay, this is not Christ right here, man, according to the Bible. Okay, Christ was a so-called black man, according to the Bible. That's what your Sunday school teacher taught you, right? Okay, that Christ was a European, okay? All right, Christ was a so-called black man, according to Ecclesiastes 41, okay, 41:78, okay? The so-called white man, that's what your Sunday school teacher taught you, okay, that Christ was a so-called white man, all right? But let me tell you something. That picture was put up for white supremacy. Okay, according to the Bible and according to facts, Christ was a so-called black man. Okay, Christ looked just like you, and Christ looked just like me. And these brothers that you see right here, that's what Christ looked like. And that's how he's coming back, man. All right, Ecclesiastes, go on and read it.
This is the book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 41, verse 7.
Bring
But children, we complain of the ungodly father.
Yeah, that's what the so-called white man is doing now, man. That's not our fault. That was a long time ago, brother Isaac.
That's right.
That
ain't our fault.
We ain't got nothing to do with that.
Right. The children.
Yeah, you got a lot of white people out here, like them people over here.
We ain't got nothing to do with that. That ain't our fault.
What we got to do with that, brother Isaac?
We're complaining.
We ain't got nothing to do with that. That was a long time ago. I love black people. I'm just still with black people. Some of my best friends are black people.
Right. Of an
ungodly father. That was my father. That was Abraham Lincoln. That ain't got nothing to do with me.
Because they shall be reproached for his sake.
Yeah, that's exactly what we're doing. Okay, we got these old Europeans out here that's being replaced. That's why you see brothers like us on every corner in the United States and throughout the earth. Okay, telling the white man to his face exactly who the hell he is and who he's not.
That's it!
That's exactly what's happening right now throughout the earth. Because why? Because we're living in the last days, man. The things that you see on the news that went on in Washington, young man, okay, guess what's going on? Those are all signs of the time, man. Okay, and our only protection, okay, is the Most High. Come and bring yourself back, okay, to the Heavenly Father. Okay, right. Like we did in the past, okay, because we got to get back to that which worked for us. Okay, not celebrating Thanksgiving, Halloween, okay, the 4th of July, okay, New Year's Eve, and Christmas. Those are all pagan holidays. I know I took the sign somewhere off, Brother Ryan. Okay, but down the street. Hey, Ryan, do me a favor and give me that sign, okay, with the so-called holiday. And I'm going to ask this young man a question. How old are you, young man? And take the mask off, bro. Don't worry about it. Nobody got the COVID up here, huh? How old are you? 11? Okay, let me ask you a question. Can you identify, okay, with some of these? Give me a Mark 7:7, Brother Diane. Okay, can you identify with some of these right here? On the board, like y'all do it on the Google Terrace, brother.
Bring it up! Bring it up!
Hey, listen, what do you identify with? What do you identify with this? Let me ask you an honest question. Okay, out of these things that you see on the sign right here, which one did you participate in lately? Don't be ashamed, brother. Which one? Oh, you said Halloween. Okay, let me ask you another question. Why? Because that's what was taught to you, right? Okay, you had to put on a mask and go around and knock on the door and ask for candy. Okay, brother, what you got to understand is this, okay, is that Halloween, things like, you can't go in the Bible and find that. Okay, I don't know if you go to church or not, and if your pastor is promoting this, brother, they go to show you that that's a lie. Give me Mark 7:7 real quick, and keep that up, brother. Okay? Okay. Oh, yeah. Keep Mark 7 here, too. All right, give me Mark 7:7.
The book of St. Mark, 7:7.
Yeah.
I read in vain.
Oh, listen up to this one. What's your name, brother? Trayvon? Trayvon. Okay, it's like Martin, huh?
Right.
Okay, all right. So the Most High said, read it one more time.
I read.
The Most High said this. He said, how be it?
In vain.
The Most High said in vain. Meaning no good, man. Meaning it's not going to do you any good to do what?
Do they worship me?
So the Most High said this, Trayvon. If you want shipping, okay, a big fat white man, and on good will your parents spent all their hard money, okay, working a 9 to 5, 5 to 9, okay, buying you toys, the Most High said, how be it in vain, okay, do our people do what?
Worship me, teaching for doctrines, the commandments of men.
The Most High said this. He said, our people teach the doctrines, okay, the commandments of men. And why did the Most High say that? Okay, because listen, okay, the teacher appears about December 25th. That's all a pagan holiday. You can't go in the Bible and find where it says Christ was born on December the 25th. Okay, that's a holiday where we can read about Nimrod. Okay, he died. Okay, and married his mother. Matter of fact, his father died. Okay, and then he married his mother. Okay, and when you read about these holidays that's in the Bible, that's pagan, that man made up. Okay, you can't go in the Bible, you can't find none of this stuff in the Bible. So why does your, let me ask you a question, brother, okay, and you know, we ain't here to shame nobody, enough like that, we're here to teach, okay, right. We're here to teach, okay, but why do your pastors, each of these things that you see here, like a tree with the lights on it, okay, the man with the red suit with the glasses and with the book and stuff like that, with the lights with the reindeer, when was the last time you seen reindeer fly? You see how silly that is, man. Okay, when was the last time you seen Easter, when was the last time you seen rabbits, okay, lay eggs, man? Rabbits have rabbits. You see how crazy that sounds right there? Okay, but yet and still, our people are so brainwashed, okay, so manipulated, okay, and so what? And so conditioned, okay, to believe everything this European, turn that around, and believe everything this European tells us to, we do, okay? And we can't get around that. And we may make excuses, okay, and say, well, it's just for the kids, I'm just doing it for the kids, okay, because why? Because it's tradition, okay? You may know better, but let me tell you like this, and give me Hosea 4 and 6, okay? The Most High says, the stupidity got to stop somewhere, okay? But we worship and stuff like this, okay, Thanksgiving. And Thanksgiving was another murderous day. Remember this right here. Thanksgiving was started by a white man by the name of John Winthrop. Okay? He waged war on the Pico Indians. Remember this right here. He waged war on the Pico Indians, okay, and then made fun, and, okay, massacred, okay, the Pico Indians, and then made fun. The turkey represents the body of North American Indians. The blood is the cranberry sauce, and the stuffing is the guts. Okay, and when you sit around every Thanksgiving, okay, and you take the turkey and you stick it on a fork, Brother Nizar, and then you get the stuffing and then you get the cranberry sauce, that's in remembrance of the slaughter of the North American Indians. So when you're eating all that on one fork, that's what you're doing. You're actually celebrating the slaughter and the downfall of the North American Indians, our brothers. Okay, read Acts 5:21.
Teach them up, teach them.
Acts 5:21, come on. The book of Acts, chapter 5, verse 21. Don't go nowhere. Stay right there. Come on.
And when they heard that they entered into the temple early in the morning and taught.
Okay, is that it? Acts 5, 21. Finish up. Come on.
It's the book of Hosea, chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge.
Mosiah said this. This is the problem right here. Mosiah said his people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. Okay, of knowledge. Okay, because why? Because society has duped us. Okay, society tells you to go out and celebrate 4th of July, Halloween, which is the most satanic day on the calendar. Okay, Christ didn't look like this. Give me Revelation. Okay, 1:13. Okay, when you celebrate things like this, this is all paper. Okay, let me ask you a question, brother. Okay, who did you talk this way about here? Okay, come on. Okay, who did you talk? This is what you did. You have all my history books at home. This will be the day, okay? All right, who did you talk that was right there, brother? I mean, be honest, man. Right. But you know that? Okay, let me prove it to you in the Bible, okay? Follow and read.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 13. And in the midst of the seven candlesticks.
Most I said this is giving the description of Christ, okay? John the Revelator on Asia Minor. Listen up real good.
When? Like a thief, the son of man!
Whenever you read the Bible, if you don't remember nothing else, remember this today. Okay, one, when you read the Bible and you talk about the Son of Man, it's talking about Jesus Christ. In Hebrew, his name is Yahushua.
Right.
Okay, come on.
Clothed with a garment down to the foot!
Okay, Christ had a long Middle Eastern garment. Okay, a little bit longer than mine. Okay, it's down to the foot. Okay, meaning it was down here to the split because that's a dress code that the Heavenly Father gave us in the law. It's 613 laws that are broken up, okay, into four different categories, okay, according to the Bible. You got your dietary laws, okay, which tells you what to eat and what not to eat, okay? All the things our people are eating today are abominable. Don't you know it's a law in the Bible that tells you not to eat pork, you're not supposed to eat pork, man? Okay, the Heavenly Father tells you that in the Bible, okay, because the things that are pig ingest, okay, a bad for you, and a pig eats anything, a hog eats anything. Okay, right. So the Heavenly Father said, look, 613 laws in the Bible, and it's broken up into four different categories, not just 10 commandments. The 10 commandments are just leading you, they're just a preference, okay, to lead you, okay, to other laws that are in the other five books. Okay, meaning if you read the other laws that are in the book, they give you a description, okay, of the 10. Okay, you got your ceremonial laws. Okay, you got your what? You got your moral laws to tell you, okay, what you're supposed to be doing, okay, that's morally wrong. Like what? Like homosexuality, man. That's wrong, man. Okay, but the society uplifts that. They're trying to what? Demasculate, okay, the black man. How the hell can two men, okay, reproduce kids, brother? That's totally impossible. Right. Okay, so why does the so-called Europeans, okay, why does the so-called Europeans, okay, I'm not directing at you, I'm just talking in general, brother, okay, why do the Europeans, why do they, okay, promote that, okay, because they're wicked as hell, man, come on, get the call on Christ, come on, play me, come on.
And his hairs were white like wool.
Moses said the hairs on Christ's head and the hairs on his face were white like wool.
And snow, and his eyes were which is a flame of fire. And he's moving like unto fire. Man.
Okay, I'm gonna let the next brother come up. All right, after these two right here. Okay, so the most I say is people like on the fine grass. Okay, in Christ. Okay, the highest I was. Okay, and still is a so-called black man. Okay, call what you got. Okay, Isaiah 9:5. All right, first book is 4:9. You got it?
Stop.
Hit it, brother.
The book Isaiah, chapter 9:5.
Yeah.
For every banner of the warrior is with
confused though. Yeah, the Most High said this. You better believe this is the future prophecy right here. The Most High said, for with every battle, okay, in the past, like the public just read earlier about history repeating itself, every battle in the past was confused noise, okay, with armor, okay, with swords and armor, okay, in the past, in the Roman and the Babylonian, okay, the Egyptian wars and stuff like that. The Most High said, for read it again.
For every battle of the warrior is with confused noise.
Every battle of the warrior, okay, is with confused noise. Okay, okay, so
a promise, wound, and blood.
Most I said, wound, wound, and blood. This is a prophecy that happened, okay, in the past. Okay, the most I said, the promise was wound and blood. Okay, but this time,
but this shall be with blood and through a fire!
That's how you know the Bible is accurate, so on point. Okay, the Most High said this time, okay, it shall be a burning of fuel, a burning and fuel of fire. Okay, America is going to be destroyed by thermonuclear destruction. Okay, because the first time the Most High destroyed this place, okay, was by water. Okay, water and fire are cleansing purification processes. Okay, first time the world is going to purify something to be in the world. This time the Most High says it's going to be a burning and fuel of fire. That hasn't happened yet, but it's going to happen. Come on, hallelujah. This condition is to the fear of this room. For I think that the fear of us has set forth us to our precious name.
Ain't nobody going to come after us.
All right, Mark tried, Malcolm tried, Jesse tried, okay, W.E. Du Bois tried, okay, the Most High said he sent forth the apostles' lands, okay, what the hell do you think is going on, man? Why the hell do you think you said brothers on the corner and put out the whole earth and the four corners of the earth saying the same damn exact thing, man? Wake up, so-called black man, Christ is black. Wake up, come out of America, okay, being a heterosexual is wrong, black man. The hell with the white man is going into slavery. Get the hell away from your enemy, black man. Okay, get the hell away from the people with this black man. And it is appointed to death.
That's exactly what happened out here. That's what, exactly what happened.
Okay, you don't care. Listen, you don't die for this. Okay, that's what you got to understand. Okay, so black man, you're black in a pure deep down pulse, man. You don't know what the hell to die for or die for, man. Okay, because the white man has brought you down to a damn cartoon level, man. That's what you're saying, white man is like a black man for the smoke. Like a damn cartoon, man. Everything that comes out, Pokemon and the things like that, that's a damn show, like a childlike mentality. Okay, come on.
Okay, you may expect to go out to the world. People go by and laugh. People go by and say, good job. Y'all got nothing else to do. Get out the corner. Okay, you may expect to go to the world. Come on. To angels, and especially to men. A lot of people think that what we're doing is going to be because they've never seen nothing like this before. Because the prophecy, the Most High said this. He said the truth is sprung really up. Okay, and that's what's going on down in this earth, man. Okay, the truth is something that sprung newly up. Okay, we are putting this out together. Come on.
This team, we don't fool for Hamashiach's sake.
That's right, we fool for the Most High's sake, man. All right, we don't give a damn about the white man, and we don't give a damn about America either, man. We're out of this damn place, man.
All right, we was this damn place blowing up all the damn night. But you know, a lot of you niggas still want to turn up. Okay, still want to those Mardi Gras spirit. Okay, still want to turn up and still want to those Mardi Gras spirit, man. You niggas are Baptists, man. I'm going to tell you, man. You ain't got nothing left, okay, in society, but you still want to put a band-aid on it, and you still want to uphold it. Come on.
Because
you
don't
preach the book of Isaiah, chapter 9, verse 16. Yeah. For the leaders of this people, cause them to err.
Yeah, the Most High said, listen, young leaders have caused you to error, man. Okay, that goes on with Lewis Farrakhan too, man. Okay, the Most High said, the leaders of these people has caused you to err. Okay, we don't give a damn. We don't need damn brethren, Al Sharpton, okay, speaking up for us, man.
Hey.
We know he's a damn hypocrite, man. He's just right. He's just a person that's an opportunist, man. We don't need Al Sharpton or Stephen A. Smith, okay, on ESPN, speaking us all the black men. That is fat damn head, man. Always going around calling a damn white man his damn brother. You're my brother. That's the reason why the so-called black man is still here in 2021 saying, we shall rule, like a bunch of damn slaves in the damn field, man. You know us all to get sick and tired of singing that damn song today, man. You still, okay, are playing and begging a damn white man for damn hope, okay, but we don't give a damn about you. The damn white man, woman, and child never cared about you, so-called black man. It's the best nigga, it's a nigga that's the damn slave, man. And that's how you feel about black people, man. But the so-called white man ain't got you black men. Okay, no one pumps the damn chunks. Come on.
Verse 17. Therefore, the Lord shall have no joy in their good men.
That's right. The Most High said he ain't gonna have no joy. Okay, that's it. The Most High said he ain't gonna have no joy. Okay, the young men. Okay, these young men today, man, they know whether the hell they wanna be women, or they don't know whether the hell they wanna be a damn man. Okay, that goes back to your damn leaders, man. And you guys black men and women, okay, that's teaching their damn kids, you guys don't believe a damn church. Okay, you can be whatever the hell you want to damn be. Okay, you need to be kicked right in your ass, man. Okay, because why? Because that's abominable, man. The damn white man has taught us to be wicked. The white man has taught us to turn, okay, towards one another, man. He taught us, genocide to kill one another. And you damn black men and women and child, okay, if you don't find out in these last days, you better get the hell away from these damn white women, man.
Right.
Okay, you better get the hell away from them, okay, you gotta be the first ones that took it off the damn scene. Okay, that's no prize. Okay, the black man think that because he's walking around with a damn white woman, okay, walking around with a damn cage, he think that's the prize in the pinnacle of damn beauty. Okay, and that woman's the ugliest damn bitch I ever seen in my damn
life.
Man, what the hell a black man want to deal with damn white women, man? Okay, you know, ugly is real stuff, man. That makes a black man feel good and he's walking around with a damn cave woman?
With a damn beast, man?
Alright? And vice versa, okay, to these black men. You probably think that the white man is doing you a favor, okay, by walking around with you. Well, the white man picked me up, pulled me on the job, you're going to take me to lunch.
Oh,
you feel so damn special. Oh, you feel like a damn earth, that's the feeling. Oh, damn bad bitch, man. They're the greatest people on this earth, okay, whether you believe it or not. And the white man is the base fine man on this planet.
That's right!
And with that, let me say, I'm like a bitch, I'm not going to speak to them up.
All praise, all praise.